Good evening, my name is Katarzyna Nowicka, and welcome to Poland Daily News. An emergency Polish cabinet council was called today by President Andrzej Duda. During almost 2 hours of deliberations, the president, prime minister and ministers discussed the Iran crisis, the Holocaust Forum in Jerusalem, and the celebrations of the 75th anniversary of the liberation of the Auschwitz concentration camp on January 27th. At a joint press conference of the prime minister and the president, after the end of the council, Andrzej Duda confirmed that Poland will not take part in the Holocaust Forum in Jerusalem.
Uważam, że brak wystąpienia prezydenta Rzeczypospolitej jako tego, który będzie mówił o tych ofiarach.
In my opinion, the lack of a possibility of the Polish president giving a speech, the one who is going to speak about the victims, the one who is going to speak about all Polish victims of the Holocaust and the Second World War, is so extremely important that the lack of such a speech is not only a blow to the Polish interests, not only a huge disservice to the memory of those righteous among the nations who were saving Jews, and some of them are heroically lost their lives, often alongside their whole families, just because they were saving their Jewish neighbors. But foremost, it is tinting the historical truth with half-truths. I do not see a reason why presidents of Russia, Germany, France, and the representatives of the United Kingdom and the United States, in such a place, on such an occasion, in connection with this important anniversary, would be allowed to speak, while the president of Poland would not be allowed to speak. This is particularly important in the light of the recent Russian narrative, and in particular from the mouth of the President of the Russian Federation, Mr. Vladimir Putin, we hear allegations addressed towards Poland that are completely against the historical truth, and they are, and I have no doubts in this, an attempt to humiliate Poles and rewrite the history of the Second World War. The lack of a possibility to speak there in this matter, I consider an infringement on Polish interests, and that is why I raised this matter during the Cabinet Council. I am grateful to all participants of the Cabinet Council. I thank you, Mr. Prime Minister, that you expressed deep understanding in this. We, unanimously, are in such a position that I will travel to take part in those celebrations only in the case that I will be scheduled to make a speech. If not, the Polish president is not going to take part in those celebrations.
We are
not allowing to be provoked by the Russian Federation, unfortunately with the lead of Mr. President Putin. In my statement a few days ago, the text of which was consulted extensively with Mr. President on each step, we had shown how the historical events unfolded about 80 years ago. We also had shown today's context of those Russian losses, like the Nord Stream 2, connected with Belarus, with a resolution of the European Parliament on the Ribbentrop-Molotov Pact, which, as Mr. President remarked today, should have been called the Hitler-Stalin Pact, as it is the case in historiography of the majority of other countries, derived from the names of leaders of Soviet Russia and Hitler's Germany in 1939.
Iranian leaders have announced 13 different scenarios of revenge on the United States for killing one of the most important people in Iran, General Qasem Soleimani. They claim that every single one of them will be like hell for America. Today, the funeral ceremony of General Soleimani was held in his hometown, Kerman.
Tensions are running high between Iran and the United States. Today, the commander of the Revolutionary Guard, General Hossein Salami, threatened that in retaliation for the murder of General Qasem Soleimani, he will order the burning down of places of high importance in the United States. These are my last words. We will get our revenge. We will get our revenge. It will be difficult, but we will make them regret what they have done. Have faith and be calm. This revenge will be crucial and final. The United States Secretary of Defense and Donald Trump himself were identified as terrorists, and they should be punished as such. Today, during the funeral ceremony of General Soleimani, over 40 people were killed and around 200 were wounded as a result of a panic attack. The United States just spent $2 trillion on military equipment. We are the biggest and by far the best in the world. If Iran attacks an American base or any American, we will be sending some of that brand new beautiful equipment their way and without hesitation. Meanwhile, the leaders of all countries and international organizations call on all parties of the conflict to cease violence and urge dialogue.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
We agree Iran must never acquire a nuclear weapon. We share concern about Iran's missile tests. And we are united in condemning Iran's support for a variety of different terrorist groups.
China, we urge the United States not to abuse any further use of force. And we also call on all relevant parties to exercise maximum restraint and talking to each other and trying to find a solution.
Don't forget that the attack on the American embassy in Baghdad was preceded by the strikes U.S. made on certain groups in Iraq. And that was a reaction, although unfortunate, and it cannot be justified in any case.
The second most important figure in Iran, General Qasem Soleimani, was killed on Thursday night at the international airport in Baghdad by an American rocket attack ordered by U.S. President Donald Trump.
During today's press conference, Speaker of the Senate Tomasz Grodzki defended himself against the accusations of him accepting bribes while working in one of the hospitals in Szczecin. Grodzki represented a recording of a man who claimed that he was offered 5,000 zloty if he confirmed that he gave Grodzki a bribe. As journalists of TVP Info gathered, the voice of the man in the recording belongs to a certain Tadeusz Staszczyk, who allegedly was once an officer of the Communist Security Office in Szczecin.
I wanted to say that on December 30th, 2019, I was approached by a man who claimed to be from the hospital. As I recently had a diagnostic endoscopic procedure there, I thought he came to me in regards to that, so I let him in. He took out his wallet and offered to pay me 5,000 zloty, given I read a statement saying that Dr. Grodzki accepted me into the hospital only after he demanded and took money from me. This is a dirty lie and defamation. The witness presented by Speaker Grodzki was once an officer of the Department of Security, which is clear from the documents of the Institute of National Remembrance. The man was surely ill and came to Professor Grodzki for treatment in the hospital. However, the question in mind is why he was chosen as the person being paid off by Grodzki. The past of this witness casts a shadow on the entire story.
Australians are paying their respects to a firefighter who died in the Australia wildfires, which have been devastating the continent since September last year. His funeral was attended by several dozen of his colleagues, as well as Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison, among others.
Andrew O'Dwyer, a volunteer firefighter, died at 36 years old. The man was crushed by a burnt tree on December 19th. Another firefighter, Jeffrey Keaton, was also involved in the deadly accident. During his funeral ceremony, dozens of officers formed a guard of honor, paying the last tribute to the deceased. The firefighter was also awarded a medal by New South Wales Fire Commissioner Shane Fitzsimmons. The award was received by the daughter of the deceased, Charlotte. Representatives of state authorities, including the Australian Prime Minister, also took part in the ceremony. The Australian Business Council, which intends to donate $25 million Australian dollars, has announced aid for children orphaned by deceased firefighters. The raging fires in Australia have burned down nearly 9 million hectares of bush since October and destroyed more than 1,000 homes. The most affected area is the east coast of the continent. Recently, fires have appeared on Kangaroo Island, devastating nearly a third of its surface. The fire destroyed the Flinders Chase National Park, located in that area, which is inhabited by healthy koalas, kangaroos, and rare species of birds. According to experts, it is estimated that around 500 million animals have died as a result of the dangerous fires.
The 77th edition of the Golden Globe Awards, honoring the best in television and film, was held on Sunday in the United States. Our correspondent Małgorzata Schulz has more.
Another Golden Globes Awards are behind us. Last Sunday, Hollywood had one of the biggest holidays and rewards that usually start new trends in fashion and new trends in film. This year, it was especially interesting, a gala, because one of the biggest celebrities were present all together. That doesn't happen all the time. Celebrities like Jennifer Aniston and Brad Pitt were seen on the red carpet at the Golden Globes after 18 years. This famous Hollywood couple hasn't been together for many, many years, but were reunited on Sunday in Beverly Hills. When it comes to Ricky Garvin, who is one of the most controversial actors in Hollywood, Many were afraid that he might start another scandal, but all his jokes were pretty calm and nobody got upset. He wasn't picking on too many people. When it comes to awards that were given for the whole career, a very famous actor, Tom Hanks, was awarded, and his speech was the best of that night. Małgorzata Schulz for Poland Daily from Los Angeles.
That's all for tonight. Now on to Poland Daily Business with Aleksander Wierzejski and his guest. Good night.